Hi, my name is David. Today we're going to be giving you a quick overview of how to apply the armor seal and give you some ideas as to where you can apply the product. All right, the first thing we'll look at is the armor seal gun. As you can see on this pistol grip gun, there's actually two settings. The farthest one out is the one that you adjust to actually pick up more product or less product. And this second one here on the back side, this is actually just a set screw. Once you get this adjustment nozzle to where you want it, just use this back one as a set screw. This is your armor seal. Here's your pistol grip gun. The quart size bottle just threads right into the gun. You hook your airline up and you're ready to go. As far as surface prep goes, it's really easy. You just want to make sure there's no loose flaky rust. If there is, just knock it off with a wire brush. There's no need to sandblast. You want to make sure that the surface is above 60 degrees. You want to make sure that it's clean and dry. You don't want a bunch of hydraulic oil or motor oil anywhere. And then also, if you've been in a salty environment, recommend that you take a look at our neutral wash. It's a salt and chloride neutralizer, and it actually neutralizes and gets rid of that white powdery salt film before you apply your armor seal. There's several places you can apply the armor seal. One would be the rear inspection plate housing, like you see here. You can also apply the armor seal to your transmission and your oil pans. You can also apply the armor seal to the frames of the truck. A couple of the nice things about the armor seal is the fact that your guys can apply this in the shop themselves, and you don't have to farm your equipment out and have things tied up for 2 or 3 days. And it only takes about 4 to 5 quarts to treat the undercarriage of a tandem axle dump truck. That one coating, that one treatment will actually last you 3 to 4 years. So for less than $100, you can save yourself a lot of troubles with your oil pans, your frames, transmission pans, your air brake chambers, things of that nature. A couple of things you want to remember on the armor seal: you never want this product to freeze. If it freezes and gets thick, I recommend that you take it back inside the office or put it on a floor register. Maybe possibly put it inside a truck if it's nice and warm outside and roll the windows up, or possibly put it in front of a torpedo heater. But you need the product to be thin and liquid. It needs to be a pourable, sprayable liquid. If it's thick, it won't shoot. And definitely encourage you not to try to thin it out with anything. If you try to thin it out, it's going to mess up the integrity of the product. You're much better off just to get that product back up to a warm room temperature. As far as cleanup goes, when you're done with the armor seal, you just want to take the bottle off, and our Rhomar, the asphalt emulsifier, will do a great job cleaning the gun out, or you can use any kind of solvent like a parts cleaner, do a great job cleaning the gun out as well. Thanks again for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it and learned a little bit. If you have any questions or would like to place an order, feel free to get a hold of us. The phone number is 1-800-688-6221. We're open Monday through Friday from 7:30 to 5 Central Standard Time. Have a good day.